Every once in a while, I get the urge to do a whole bunch of art practice and up my art skills, so I decided it would be fun to challenge myself to practice a different topic each month. For November, I chose big cats. I picked big cats for two reasons. Number one, this is the topic I always default to whenever I get the urge to practice after a long period of time. What can I say? I like cats and I think they're cool. And number two, many years ago, I made a little Mage Tower Feral Druid model for my friend, but she moved, and the moving people weren't gentle with her stuff, and it got broken. So now she wants me to make another one for her, so I need to refresh myself on big cat anatomy. This isn't the first time I've studied how to draw big cats, it's more like the fourth or even fifth time. I have a bad habit of taking long breaks and forgetting what I've learned, and I'd really like to stop doing that. Thus the whole, you know, new topic every month thing. I wanna keep at it. In the past, I learned from following guides such as How to Draw Big Cats by Aaron Blaze, and books such as The Complete Guide to Drawing Animals by Gottfried Bams. I don't know how to pronounce that. However, this time, since it's mostly a review, I just studied from photos I found on Google Images. To begin the process and try to get more efficient at learning, I started out by asking myself a question. What are the proportions of the head of a lion? I chose lions to start with since they are the quintessential big cat and tend to have short fur and no patterns, which makes viewing muscle groups a lot easier. However, to make this simpler for myself, I focused only on lionesses because it's a lot easier to learn muscle groups around the neck and shoulder area, but you don't have to worry about a thick mane. Okay, I'm just going to go through this quickly just to show my progress and, you know, my methods and how to do things. I did initially make a recording covering everything, but it was like 40 minutes long, and I want this to be a nice short 20-minute video. So to start off with, I just took a picture of a lioness's head from Google Images. All these images are going to be from Google Images. And then I just traced over it and got the proportions and then practiced a bit. And then took another one, did the same thing, trying to simplify. So the goal is to find a method to be able to replicate this without the use of references eventually. Like, people, when they're learning art, I think a lot of people are like, oh no, I can't use references. It's copying. I gotta learn to draw things from my head. And like, no, use references. So I wrote down like a methodology here. And then did the same for the front of the face, right? Getting those proportions. As you can see, these heads look a bit strange. I think I played around a lot with the eyes, like the eye width. So there's supposed to be like a four eye width gap between the eyes. So these eyes are a bit too big. The gap isn't big enough. I think the one down here is the best example of that. And once I got the front and side proportions, I was like, okay, we got to figure out how to do this in two thirds. And these heads do not look good. I'll admit to that. very rough. I think like, okay, this first head I did and I was like, okay, this is clearly wrong. Let's try again. And it's still a bit wrong, but I think slightly better. And then I just kept doing it. And these ones look all right, but the muzzles are too short. Lions have like nice long muzzles compared to other cats. Yeah, these ones are looking, this bottom one here looks pretty good. I think this might be from a reference. So some of these are me trying to draw it from reference, and other ones are just drawing from my head, like trying to come up with a system to draw like a line however I want to without needing the full reference. So here's an example of kind of the thought process. Like, so I draw one head. I think this is from reference, and I'm like, okay, there's something wrong with it. What's wrong? You know, identify what's wrong with it. Okay, it's too thin. It should be wider. So then I drew it again, a bit wider this time, and it's like, oh, that looks a lot better. So, and then some more drawings, trying to kind of figure out shapes and proportions. And then, yeah, so then after that, I moved on to what do the eyes look like? Because the eyes are the windows of the soul, after all. So here's some practice eyes, just basic shapes, not getting too details, not like no rendering going on, just your basic shape and trying to figure out, okay, how big is the eyeball and how much of it like shows versus is hidden within the eye socket. Now, eyes, so I'm drawing like fairly realistic eyes here, or I'm going for fairly realistic lion eyes. Some people draw them a bit more anthropomorphic, a bit anthropomorphic, I can't pronounce it. A bit more like, okay, so if you've watched the if you've watched The Lion King, you know those eyes look a bit more human, like they're, you know, they're bigger, they're more emotive, they got eyebrows to emote with. These ones I'm drawing are not, these are supposed to be just normal lion eyes. And then here I'm trying to add the eyes like into the head, like trying to get the position of the eyes right, and as well as the shape and size and all that. So this one, this head looks okay, but the eyes are a bit too wide apart. This one is a bit better. You can see up here I say 3.5 gap instead of 4. This is just me experimenting, a bit more stylized, but I eventually just go back to the 4 gap. I'm going for realism here, not a semi-real or cartoony. And then just a side view there. So some more practice. Now this is the side views look pretty good. It's the 3-4 views that are at the hardest, right? Because you gotta like actually understand the shapes if you're gonna do it at a weird angle. So as you can see, this head looks very funky. I tried adjusting it, like, so I just made a copy, shrunk it down, and adjusted the eyes a bit, and it's still a bit funky. It's wrong. And then some more drawings. I'd say the best one is the bottom one in terms of shape and proportions, but yeah, this still looks a bit weird. Okay. So I was like, okay, I need a way to draw the line heads simply. So this is me trying to figure out methods that I can quickly, you know, draw a circle, draw a second circle for the muzzle, and then like place everything in, you know, with like as few guidelines as possible. So once again, side views are easy, right? It's the 3-4 views that are the, 3-4 views that are the hard part. Okay, so this here, more practice. I'm starting to kind of get a handle of it. I don't know what size at this point to make the muzzle circle. Eventually figure out, where is it? Yeah, here I'm thinking, okay, these circles are too small. I need to make them bigger. Okay, so now I figured out, okay, let's make the snout circle 2/3 of the head circle, right? Because, like, remember the muzzle, the width of the muzzle is the same as the width of the eyes, like from the outer edge to the outer edge. So they're pretty big. They're looking a bit better. The muzzles are starting to look better. So I'm like, okay, that's enough of that. How about, like, skulls? Because, like, I want to be able to add, like, teeth to my lion heads, like, you know, if they're roaring or growling or chewing something up. So how do I place the teeth? And to do that, you gotta know how to place the skull. So I tried, like, okay, let's do a big circle, do a small circle, and fit the skull in, and I accidentally made the skull like way too big. So I tried it again, but this time fitting within the confines of the circle for the most part, and then kind of concentrating on that front bit with the teeth, right? Because, like, I'm interested in the teeth. And one thing I did is, like, okay, I took some pictures of some lionesses, and then I drew skulls over them, like, try to figure out where everything kind of lines up. So this top left image is this is drawn from, like, a reference. Like, if you just look up lion skull, you'll see, like, one of the images there looks a lot like this. And then I use that as a reference to draw these skulls over the lioness heads. And then this one down here is me trying to draw the skull, from this image, so from the original reference, but I'm doing it like flipped to try and like practice it. That's a trick they teach you in art school sometimes, is like if you flip an image upside down, you kind of break down the shapes a bit easier because you're not like recognizing it as like a face or whatever. It's a weird brain trick. So this is just like another practice skull. So, well, like, without using a reference, I'm like, can I draw skull and the lioness? And then I try drawing the skull again, like outside the line. It looks a bit funky, but like, so I'm mostly like worried about the teeth for now. So anyways, after that I'm like, okay, what about a snarling lion? Okay, so we got a growling lion there, And then here's me trying to draw it. I'm not drawing like the shapes over the image of the head. I'm more worried about this line here, which indicates it's supposed to help you kind of line up the bottom jaw with the top jaw when it's open, because it works, it's like on a hinge, right? And this image, this drawing looks pretty good. So we got another one. Once again, same process. The wrinkles on top of the muzzle are, I'd say, the hardest part. Now this muzzle or jaw, I made it a bit too long, as you can see. I tried drawing it again, slightly shorter. But yeah, those wrinkles are kind of hard to get right. Some more drawings. I can't remember if these are from reference or not. Just trying to get the teeth right, trying to get, you know, the eyes right, like ears, and then of course the nose and the wrinkle. The nose tends to get like squished a bit. I'm pretty sure that's from reference. Another one from reference, side view. They're a bit less bumpy, but it's still like a little bit bumpy. And the teeth just kind of showing a little bit. And yeah, that's a crazy expression. And the other one's just yawning. I can't remember if they're both from reference or not. I think the one on the left is from reference. I'm not sure about the one on the right. And then yeah, and I think these are not from reference. So these are me trying to like draw it myself without a reference, or not direct reference. Like I might start out drawing something without a reference, and then okay, wait, I'm stuck, and then go look at a reference. These are starting to look better. So compared to my head's earlier, it's starting to get a lot better. And then just some practice. Just some doodling practice, basically. So I initially just like draw it. I'd use the gray circles as kind of guidelines and then fill in the rest with the black. And yeah, so it's starting to look good. The snout here looks a bit strange. I think it's a bit too curved. I think the angle needs to be a bit sharper there. And then doing some fur. I'm not very good at drawing fur. Lions have very fluffy ears, but they're not like that fluffy, I think. Okay, so then I'm like, okay, body. We gotta work on the body, right? Because my original goal was to make a model, little polymer clay model for my friend. So I'm like, okay, proportions. And I'm getting these proportions from a book. I think I mentioned it earlier, Complete Guide to Drawing Animals by Gottfried Bams. And it gives you, okay, like based on the head length, this is the height, this is the length. The length is about 1.2 times the height. So if you draw a box to contain the body, that's the proportion you're going for. And then I had to figure out the front proportions myself, because that wasn't in the book. It's just side proportions. That's one of the annoying things about like learning sometimes, is like you can't quite find the resources you need. You gotta just figure it out on your own. So I got like the practice of side view and then the front view. Then I'm like, okay, let's angle this a bit, 3/4 it. And so this is me trying to place it, the body, into like 3D space. And yeah, I'm not too good at that. It's something I need to work on. So here's some sketches, another side view, trying to get the body right, you know, without the box, just trying to kind of eyeball it. And then another 3/4 view. I think this might be used from reference or drawn from reference. Some more sketches. I think this one I drew myself. That face looks a bit strange. So sometimes you get really, like, you draw like a really good line face, it's like, yeah, I got it, and then like the next day it's like, oh, why am I bad again? But yeah, trying to get the proportions, like the length, the body right. Yeah, these are definitely from reference. So like this one's crouching, you know, because they're not always just standing nice and still and stuff. Sometimes you get like weird angles. And then here's me trying to draw from my head, no references. So I drew this and I was like, you know, this is too short. Like I was trying to foreshorten it a bit, and I'm not good at foreshortening. So this butt needs to be back a bit. And then same with this one. So I initially drew it, then I was like, okay, the body is not long enough. So before I put the black lines over top of the gray lines, I just like lassoed the bottom half and just dragged it down. Yeah, these are also just some sketches. So I kind of figured out, actually, I think I saw like another kind of, I was looking up other guides online too, like how to do this, and one of them had this kind of like shape over the shoulders. And then also I studied like, okay, what about a stretching lion? So you know, the shoulders actually move forward quite a bit for that. They're nearly touching the head, like the neck almost disappears. Okay, so that's the proportions of the lion's body. Okay, next I was like, okay, what shapes make up the lion? So it's similar to earlier when I was like, oh, I need ways of simplifying the head. I was like, you know, I gotta break this down. Because if I'm going to draw like a lion or any kind of cat or animal in like, you know, space, like a 3D space and at a in a position that I want it to, that where there might not be like a reference, proper reference for it, I need to like break it down the shapes and be able to like change it. So here you can see I took these photos and I traced over it with like red lines. I'm trying to get these basic shapes. I had a lot of trouble with like the chest and shoulder area. But then once I did that, I was like, okay, let's, instead of copying these photos, let's try and use these shapes to kind of construct a new lion that's in a different position. And that's what I did, and it's okay. The heads still look a bit funny. And I did it again, but this time even like simpler. I'm like, okay, we really gotta like simplify the shape. So I kind of came up with this shape. I call it the Amogus shape for the shoulders. I think you can kind of see why. And then it's the body here. So the rib cage is right here. And then after that, it's the kind of rectangular-ish cylinders. Then, yeah, the rest. And then I'm like, okay, now let's transfer this to like a moving line. So here's me using the shapes to kind of construct a line in motion. Here's some more practice. So some of these are like I come back like a day later and I gotta like review what I learned the previous day or a couple days ago. As you can see, this face did not work very well. But yeah, some more sketches. These are not from reference, I don't think. These are just me free drawing, having some fun. The mittens, I'm like, okay, I'll like learn paws a bit later. So right now we got the murderless murder mittens. Yeah, and then yeah, another stretching line. And then here's just some kind of gesture drawings, but like with no reference. Once again, just me trying to do it from imagination with what I learned. And yeah, so that's the me learning bodies. So I'm like, okay, we got to refine this bit. So what about muscles? So I found these reference images. So we got this one 3D model that somebody made, and then this image of an actual lioness with like ripped muscles. Like she works out, she lifts. And so I just like, okay, we gotta go over the shapes. I have like in blue here, I was like, okay, this is approximately where the bones are, and then red, it's like how they join up. So lions, they kind of have this like line here, and this is the shoulder blade where the all the muscles attach. And the muscles themselves are it's a bit complicated to learn. Like when you get down to it, it's basically just like bicep and triceps and all that. See, it's all the same muscles you have in your body, in your arm, but it's just rearranged differently and they're different sizes. Once again, I'm flipping, so when I'm trying to draw it again from the image, I'm like flipping it to try and like make sure I kind of understand how it's actually constructed. And I'm also trying to figure out proportions. So I'm like, okay, the top of the shoulders to the elbows, like one half, and then one half. And then, yeah, so practicing muscles. And then, all right, same thing, use the same image for the hind legs. I just put it in two separate layers. And the hind leg is like, okay, the knee is at one half, but then like the heel, well, not like the heel, but like right here, this bend here is about 1/4. So half of half. And then the leg itself is a bit simpler and easier to remember than the arm, I find. Okay. And then me trying to like rotate it. which is tricky. It's also hard, really hard to find images of the inside of the leg. Like, there's certain angles that are like, oh man, I wish I had a proper reference for this, and you just can't find a good photo. I mean, I think it's kind of hard to take a picture of a lion. They'll eat you, so understandable. I drew in gray, like that kind of base, the base shapes, the amogus, and the rest of the body. Then I went over in red for to kind of like attach the muscles, and then went over it again in black to just kind of like draw it in. Now, a lot of the time, like a lot of these muscles you don't really see on the cat because they're covered in skin and fur, and it depends if they're like flexing or not. So this is just front. Like I'm trying to figure out this chest area, right? Also, I think for briefly, I was like, oh, I should learn the muscles on the forearm. Yeah, the main thing of the forearm is you gotta know where like this bone is. So this is like, there's like a bone here, and then kind of divides the arm up. Anyways, I was like, okay, that's enough of that. What did the paws look like? So here are the paws. So I started like, okay, there's a circle. There's like a shape here. And then I kind of divided them up into toes and drew the paw pads in. So the paw pads, they got these like three lobes here. And then it's like a little divot up here. And then they got this like thing over here, like opposite to their thumb. The hind paws are a lot simpler. It's just like a really long shape. They got the same, this thing. And then me trying to draw paws. And then I'm looking at the anatomy of a paw, and I'm trying to like break it down and trying various ways of drawing paws. None of them really look good. Just practicing paws. I don't know if I'm much to say. You just gotta kind of like try various things until something works. And eventually I'm like, okay, these look all right. And then attaching the paws to the rest of the arm. So once again, I just start with the amogus shape, and then at the muscles, the forearms, and then at the rest of the paws. And here's like the claws coming out. And then there's just like a full body sketch of some of the muscles, like the mainly forearm muscles, and then the claws are out. And then I don't know, this is just like a zoom in I did. Okay. And then next was just a bunch of practice. So I drew like this lion, still practicing. All right. I did kind of line this one. It looks all right. See, I'm starting to get the hang of the head. I find when I sleep on things, I magically get better at them. So this is like a few days later, starting to get good looking heads. Got this lion. This is a very sketchy lion. Just more practice. More practice. Okay, so this one, I drew this, and I like the body, but I put the head at a weird angle, and I was like, you know, they don't hold their heads like that. Like, if they're gonna like turn and look at you, they're gonna keep the head level. So I drew it again. I just like copy and pasted the body into a new layer, erased the head, and drew it again. I was like, this is a good lion right here. I'm gonna actually like use this for like a full art piece I want to do, like the kind of final study. And then there's just like a couple more, some gesture drawings here and stuff. Me trying to break down the shapes even simpler. Yeah. So anyways, back to this line. This is the base for what I decided to be the final study for the project for the month. I wanted to draw a primal stalker, which is a druid shapeshift form from World of Warcraft, obtainable in the Legion expansion. I thought it was very pretty and I wanted to draw it.
Thank you.
So here's the final version, final drawing. I was doing a lot of experimenting too while I was at it. Also, very simple background. I think that's going to be my theme for December, is backgrounds. I've always been kind of bad at backgrounds and scenery. Anyways, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed my little art video. Probably going to make it a monthly thing. Goodbye.